everyone. I am Inian, working as an assistant professor in Pratisha Engineering College. Today I am going to handle the topic on Astable Multivibrator using 555 timer. Basically, the 555 timer consists of 3 5 kilo ohm resistors which will act as a voltage divider network, and it will provide the bias current of 2 by 3 of VCC to the lower comparator and 1 by 3 of VCC to the upper comparator. We know that the concept of comparator is when the non-inverting input terminal voltage to the comparator is high when compared to the inverting input terminal voltage, output of the comparator should be high, otherwise it is low. Here the trigger input voltage is given to the inverting input terminal of the lower comparator, and 1 by 3 of VCC is given to the non-inverting input terminal of the lower comparator. When 1 by 3 of VCC is greater than the inverting input terminal of the lower comparator, output of the lower comparator is high. It means that it sets the control flip-flop. Set means the output of control flip-flop is Q equal to 1 and Q bar equal to 0. If Q bar equal to 0 is given to the base of transistor Q1 and input to the power amplifier. Since Q bar equal to 0, output of power amplifier is 1, because the power amplifier will basically act as an inverter circuit. And then the Q1 will act as a discharging transistor which is connected in the junction of RA and RB. Since Q1 equal to 0, the voltage resistor capacitor starts to increase from 0 to maximum of 2 by 3 of VCC through the resistors RA and RB. When the voltage across the resistor, when the voltage at pin number 7 is greater than 2 by 3 of VCC, the upper comparator goes high. Upper comparator goes high means it resets the control flip-flop. It resets means Q equal to 0 and Q bar equal to 1. Q bar equal to 1 means the transistor Q1 is on, the output of power amplifier is 0. When the discharge transistor is on, the voltage resistor capacitor starts to discharge through RB. So by charging, the capacitor will charge towards RA and RB through VCC. So at the time, the charging time constant is RA plus RB into C. While discharging, the capacitor is discharging through RB. So discharging time constant is RB into C. Simply we can say that when VCC by 3 is greater than VC, when VCC by 3 is greater than VC, lower comparator output is high, so it sets the control flip-flop S equal to 1 and R equal to 0. When S equal to 1, Q bar equal to 0, so transistor Q1 is off and the output is high. So Q1 off means, since Q1 is off, the capacitor starts to charging through RA and RB towards VCC with the time constant RA plus RB into C. Similarly, when the voltage across the capacitor is greater than 2 by 3 of VCC, when voltage across the capacitor is greater than 2 by 3 of VCC, R equal to 1 and S equal to 0. That means output of upper comparator is high, so it resets the control flip-flop. Reset means R equal to 1 and S equal to 0. So Q bar equal to 1. So output is low, transistor Q1 is on, so capacitor starts to discharge through RB with time constant RB into C. Now let us see the timing sequence of Astable Multivibrator. This is the trigger input we are applying at pin number 2. And this is the output of Astable Multivibrator, that is a voltage across the capacitor. Okay, when the voltage across the capacitor charges from 0 to 2 by 3 of VCC, the time taken is T1. First, initially, the voltage across the capacitor is assumed to be VC equal to VCC into 1 minus e power minus T by RC. Time T1 is the T1 is the time taken by the capacitor to charge from 0 to 2 by 3 mVcc. So the maximum voltage is 2 by 3 mVcc. So 2 by 3 mVcc equal to Vcc into 1 minus E4 minus T by RC. When you simplify this, we will get T1 equal to 1.09 RC. Similarly, let us assume the time taken by the capacitor to charge from 0 to 1 by 3 mVcc is T2. So the maximum voltage is 1 by 3 mVcc. So 1 by 3 mVcc equal to Vcc into 1 minus E4 minus T2 by RC. When you simplify this, we will get T2 equal to 0.49 RC. So we want to calculate the charging time period. Here the capacitor charges from 1 by 3 mVcc to 2 by 3 mVcc. So when you subtract this time duration, that is T1 minus T2, we will get the charging time period. So charging time period T1 minus T2 is nothing but T high equal to T1 minus T2. So 1.09 RC minus 0.405 RC is equal to 0.769 RC. So here the capacitor will charge towards RA and RB, through RA and RB towards VCC. So R can be written as RA plus RB. So T high, the high time period equal to 0.69 into RA plus RB into C. So next we want to calculate the discharging time period. Here the capacitor discharges from 2 by 3 mVcc to 1 by 3 mVcc. So 2 by 3 mVcc equal to 1 by 3 mVcc to E power minus T by RC. When you simplify this, we will get a T equal to 0.69 RC. So low time period, T low equal to 0.69 RB into C. Why I wrote RB means the capacitor starts to discharge through RB towards ground. So 0.69 into RB into C. So total time period is nothing but this is T high, this is charging period T high, and this is T low. So total time period is nothing but T high plus T low. So T high plus T low, so T high value is 0.69 into RA plus RB into C, and T low is 0.69 RB into C. When you add this, we will get the total time period across the capacitor is nothing but 0.69 into RA plus 2 RB into C. So we know that the frequency of assembled material is nothing but 1 by time period. So 1 by 0.69 into RA into RB into C. So F equal to 1.4 by RA plus 2 RB into C. Thank you.